Look at this photo, or listen to this recording. What do these two have in common? The photo contains specks of light, called noise. The voice recording also contains background noise. In the real world, professional software is used to minimize these kinds of noises. Programs like Audacity and Lightroom work using something called signal processing, which uses a mathematical technique called the Fourier transform.
Signal processing is the technique of processing a signal to isolate or obtain the more useful information, such as the recording of a voice, and to remove unwanted information, such as the background noise. And since a signal is essentially any waveform that is a function of time, signal processing is not limited to photos and voice recordings. Signal filtering works using a system called an LTI, or a linear shift invariant system. Such a system has two simple properties. Firstly, as implied by the name, the system has to be linear. That is, if we input this red wave and this blue wave separately into the system and obtain the corresponding two outputs, then if we input a sum of the red and blue wave, we will get a sum of the two corresponding outputs. This is called the superposition principle. Secondly, it has to be time invariant. Suppose we input this blue wave now and get the corresponding output. Then if we input this blue wave 1 hour later, we should still expect to get the same corresponding wave. This symmetry in line, described by Noether's theorem, is important because it conserves the total energy of the input wave function.
Let's see how the LTI system works to filter some background noise. Suppose we have a recording of a voice, but mixed in the recording, there is an undesirable low frequency hum in the background. We would take our sound recording and pass it through the LTI system, which in this case can be an auto filtering application. Then, in this application, we apply a filtering function, such as this one, to the recording. If we superpose these two wave functions, we get a new recording that only has the high frequency recording that we want, and does not have any undesirable low frequency hum.
Physically, the LTI system works because of the impulse function, also called the Dirac Delta function. When a wave function, or we call it a signal, is passed through a system, we apply the impulse function corresponding to the specific signals that we want.
But wait, we said earlier that the recording we have is a function of time. So then, how do we separate the different sound frequencies to isolate the sound that we do not want? The solution comes from a mathematical technique called the Fourier transform. In 1822, Joseph Fourier published his work on heat flow, in which he showed that the functions of a variable can be converted into a series of sinusoidal functions. This was originally used to convert periodic functions to a sum called the Fourier series. Later, it was generalized to non-periodic functions using the Fourier transform.
So then, when we apply the Fourier transform to our sound recording, we can decompose one recording into the various frequencies that it was originally composed of. Then, it will be easy to isolate the frequencies that are undesirable and apply our audio filter to remove them. Once the filter is applied, the inverse Fourier transform is applied, and we get back our sound recording as a function of time.